Hi, and welcome to my YouTube channel, Boy in a Tree, and on this channel I talk about my first book, Joshua Tree, and the second book, Joshua Tree Finds Peace, and today I'm going to be talking about chapters 8 through 14, and yeah, I'm outside, I'm wearing this, and if you follow my Instagram, you know why I'm wearing this, but anyways, that's not the point of this video. The point of this video is talking about chapters 8 through 14 in the book, Joshua Tree Finds Peace. And these chapters, there is a lot to talk about. And I have notes here of just all this general stuff I need to talk about to skim my way through it. Again, I want to make some more fun videos, but to do that, I feel like I need to just talk about get decently through the second book. So that's why, you know, because that's what I do. I write and I'm an author. And so I want to talk about my stories, and that's what this whole channel is about. So that's what I'm doing. And once I get decently through this book, I will make some fun videos, just for fun. Okay. So, but today I'm talking about chapters 8 through 14. And again, if you want to buy these books, the link down below is to buy them, so you get a little bit more detail of what I'm talking about, in these videos, because everything I'm talking about is just so generally said that, because it would just take too long to go into all the details. So everything is very general, everything is just brief summaries, so bear with me, you know. Just if you read the book, you'll understand more of what I'm talking about. So, chapters 8 through 14, lots to talk about, a lot happens in these books, in these chapters, so let's just jump into it. So in chapter 8, we first start off with Alistair, who's the demon of this story. He is just kind of going on his own little adventure. He's going to a bad place, which, again, that's generally all I'm going to say is he's going to a bad place to get some answers to, you know, figure out what's going on necessarily. He's just going somewhere to get some answers. And yeah, so that's where we leave off, and then we jump to Jonathan and Joshua Tree, which in the last video I talked about, Jonathan had tased Joshua Tree, and he knocked Joshua Tree out, and he took Joshua Tree basically to Joshua Tree's van, the van that he lived in since he was like a little kid. Jonathan ended up taking him to that, to the van, and why, and well, that's something, again, those are the small details that I go into a little bit more in the book of why they're there. So yeah, then Jonathan is just kind of talking to Joshua Tree. They do a lot of talking in the van. Jonathan's just kind of interrogating him a little bit. He's trying to figure out what's going on. And basically Jonathan, we get more of a backstory on Jonathan. So Jonathan Lang, this was a mistake that I made with Jonathan Lang. Jonathan Lang, his last name, Lang, is actually German. I thought it was Asian, and I feel a little bad about that, a little bit of ignorance there. I thought Lang was an Asian last name, but I learned that it was actually it's German. Apparently, I looked it up, though, it does have some Chinese origins, but it's, I think, mainly German. So, that gave Jonathan more of an interesting backstory, I thought. So, I went into more, and this is something that we kind of learn in this chapter too, so that's why I'm going into it. This sounds like something that would be in a What is Wrong with Joshua Tree video that I've done before, but because this is a mistake I made. But it just was interesting for Jonathan, though, because then what we learn is that basically Jonathan was adopted. He is Asian, he's Chinese, but he was adopted by a German family. So that just adds more of a backstory to Jonathan and his backstory. And that we learn a little bit about in this chapter. So that was a little mistake I made. Sorry for my ignorance, but I learned. So yeah, so now, then by the end of chapter 8, we have Joshua Tree mention his family, because most of them died. A lot of them passed away in the first book. And he just wonders also where his mother is at, Jean Tree. He's wondering where she's at. Which brings us to chapter 9, where Jean Tree is in a bathtub full of blood. Well, she's killed a lot of people. She's at a hotel. She got away from all the chaos that happened in the first book, at the house, and she just ran away. And she's now at in this hotel or an apartment an apartment building, and she's killed a lot of people, or she's killed some people, and she ends up running into a new character that I'm not gonna say his name yet, but she runs into a new character in this chapter, and he's actually okay. So I can't say his name because I don't say it in this chapter, so I don't want to say it yet. But he is just a really big character that has a bigger part to play later on, and he's a great fighter, and he ends up fighting Jane Tree because he's pissed off at her because she's killed his sister in this chapter. So he's a great fighter, and he actually puts up a great fight against Jane Tree, which is amazing because right now Jane Tree, again, she's a monster right now. She has powers, she has supernatural strength, speed, and all that. So the fact that he can put up a fight with her is amazing. He has a grapple gun, which is kind of cool. there's a lot more to this character, but and also we learned that he's Indian, though, in the story. He's an Indian character, and that's generally all we know. He's a great fighter. That's generally all we learned in this chapter about this character. So that's kind of what happens. So they're just fighting right now. Jean Tree's fighting this new character, and she's just getting really frustrated as she's fighting this new character. So that's where we leave off with the in that chapter. Chapter 10, we go back to Kate Iris. We find out what she's doing, which right now she's trying to help Nicholas, who's, again, he's weak. I talked about this in the last video. He's weak. He's on the bloody couch. He's really weak. So she's out trying to find souls to replenish his strength. So to do that, she has to, unfortunately, I guess, kill people. But Kid Iris just doesn't necessarily care, and she just kind of has to do what Nicholas tells him to do, because that's just the situation with Kid Iris. So so she's right now at a mall, and she's out trying to find some souls to go and help Nicholas. Then we flash back to Jonathan Lang and Tree and Joshua Tree, and they're just generally talking about Joshua Tree's basically informing Jonathan on everything that's happened to him in book one. He's just telling Jonathan generally everything. And then they start to have a fight because Jonathan Lang, of course, wants to kill Jean Tree, Joshua Tree's mother, but Joshua Tree, of course, doesn't like that because it's his mother. He just doesn't agree with that, of course. So they start going into a bit of a debate, and that with Jean Tree and whether or not to kill her, or at least Joshua Tree is just getting really frustrated. And then Lizzie ends up showing up randomly out of nowhere. She knocks outside the van, and this scares the hell out of them. And then she just basically ends up agreeing with Jonathan on killing Jean Tree, which is just really frustrating Joshua Tree. He's just starting to get really angry because he doesn't want to kill his mom, right? It's just, that's not something he's gonna do. So that's where we leave on chapter 10. We're almost there, almost to chapter 14. Okay, and then chapter 11, again, we go back to Kate Iris, and she's still at the mall. And Alistair shows up. He doesn't necessarily show up, but it's more like a psychic thing. It's more of a psychic thing, and he messes with Kate Iris's mind, and he just kind of tortures her, basically. So that's what generally happens in chapter 11. Chapter 12, Jean Tree, or Joshua Tree, gets frustrated again. He's still fighting with Lizzie and Jonathan Lang at this point, because they want to kill him. And then he just gets frustrated enough that he just gets out of there, and he gets out of the van. And it's pouring rain right now, but he doesn't care, and he starts walking away. And he runs into Kate Iris. Which is a bit confusing, because then in chapter 13, we do a bit of it shows the timeline of whatever, because then we go back to Kate Iris at the mall, and I put in the book a half hour ago. So basically everything that's happened to Kate Iris at the mall and onward was a half hour before everything that happened with Joshua Tree and Jonathan and Lizzie. You kind of get what I'm saying? That it makes a little bit more sense with the book if you just kind of read and follow it through. It makes a little bit more sense. But so we're back with Kate Iris at the mall, which was a half hour before Joshua Tree actually ran into her after his fight with Lizzie and Jonathan. So this is now in chapter 13 with Kate Iris, who is being tortured by Alistair mentally, and she gets out of there basically. He tortures her mentally in like terrible ways, shows her he messes with her badly, and she flies away. She literally flies away. Kate Iris can fly. That's kind of one of her powers thing. It's kind of part of her character. She gets out of there, she flies away. And she flies all the way back through to her home, and she sees that Nicholas is gone, because he was on the bloody couch, the couch with all the blood. That's not Nicholas's blood. Nicholas is actually gone, and next to the couch is a little girl who is clearly possessed. Chapter 14, we made it. This is it, the last chapter that I'm talking about today. The new character, we go back to Jean Tree, and the new character that she was fighting, he ends up getting away, but he's injured by Jean Tree, but he gets away with his awesome grappling gun. He gets away. Jean Tree was about to follow him when a young boy who is also possessed, clearly possessed, appears out of nowhere in front of her. And this possessed boy tells Jean Tree to go to the hospital that Joshua Tree was born. She just basically ends up, she goes running to the hospital. The boy just told her some things. I think, again, that's more detailed. Basically, the young boy tells Jean Tree to go to the hospital and she ends up going. Then also we flash back to Kate Iris with this young girl next to the couch, and the young girl tells Kate Iris to go to this hospital also. So Kate Iris ends up going to the hospital. And that is generally it. That is a lot to talk about. That was just a ton, but thank you for bearing with me through that. Again, if you read the books, this makes a lot more sense. Everything I'm saying is just so general, but that is generally what happens in chapters 8 through 14 in Joshua Tree Finds Peace. Again, I want to make some more fun videos on this channel, but I want to make my way through this book and just talk about everything that just generally happens, because I just feel like it's important to me. So thank you for bearing through this with me. Stay connected. I'll be doing another video. I'll be continuing from chapters like 15 and onwards. I'll do another big chunk there. Thank you for getting through this. Stay connected, and I'll see you guys in the next video. That was a lot of talking.